Okay, we're back in Santa Fe, and this piece is also for my big collector event. And this piece is a morning, called Morning's Song. I have that morning sun just hitting those clouds, and it's going to pop into this painting. And what we're going to do is let that light, it's going to come through the window. I've got my Adobe colors mixed up. In fact, let me see if I can show you here. There's all my Adobe mixtures. And they're mixes of, all of them are the same, mixing the same colors. I've just mixed my mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. And then I've added cadmium orange to that. And then just a tiny, tiny touch of phthalo blue and then white. And these are all mixed from the same, the blue color is just ultramarine blue plus white, but everything else is mixed from that basic combination. And it's amazing all the different values and hues that you can get just with those, mixing those colors. But I'm letting the light come in. You can see I've got that dark side of the gate there, and I'm going to lighten that. The sun is just pouring in through this gate. And I'm just coming back over that dark paint. It's still wet, but I can just bring my light back over it, and it doesn't matter if that mixes in a little bit. So I don't want it to be, the light in the morning is not a real intense, but I just want to do that gate, that side of that post. Now on the back part of it, I make that a little bit cooler or bluer so that the back part of that falls back. I also want it a little bit darker so that my light on the mountains back there pops. So you kind of are, it's pushing and pulling. You want the back edge of that cooler and darker, but then the front edge, we want it to be lighter and warmer. And I wipe my brush. I use just plain old, the cheapest toilet tissue that I can get, because I go through a lot of it. And that keeping the brush clean keeps the paint on your canvas nice and crisp and clean. Now I may come back later and highlight that edge, that front edge a little bit, but I'm going to wait because I don't want that to be too bright right there. And it can be rough. That old Adobe buildings are not real smooth, so. Doesn't matter if that's kind of a rough texture. So we've got that. Now I'm going to work on the wall over here where the door is. And this up under the eave of this little, where the roof comes out, it's going to be a little darker. It's right up there in under shadow. And I'm going to have over the door, the window, and the arch, I'm going to have an inlay of bricks. So I'm not going to worry about those right now. Now this wall recedes, and I washed in my clematis yesterday with magenta plus liquin and dioxinine purple plus liquin. And I just washed it in because I like that luminosity of that over the white canvas. So I'm working around that. It's dry now, so I don't have to worry about the color picking up the color into my brush. But what I'm going to do on this wall right here, the back edge, is again, where that wall goes back, I want that to be bluer so that we visually on our two-dimensional canvas can give the feeling of three dimensions. So I make that back in the corner a little bit cooler, bluer. And that'll visually, when the painting's done, that'll drop that back in there. Now I'm having flowers right there, so I'm not going to paint. come back and... This is under this little shelf sticking out. That's going to be a little bit darker because that's more in shadow. Doesn't get quite as much light as it does up higher. And then my side of the door frame then is going to be darker. So I use my darker mixture. This mixture has more mud in it so that it makes it darker. And again, the back edge of this little door, side of the door frame there, is made bluer so it falls back. That rattling is just where I have the tissue hanging off the side of my palette. Jack devised a little wire that we can just loop through the hole of the toilet tissue, and that holds the tissue there. So I only have to use one hand when I grab it. Don't have to put my brush down. I can just reach down and grab it. And good to go. So. He came up with all sorts of neat little contraptions and things like that that were very, very helpful. So I want the front edge to be a little bit lighter, bring it forward, but it's warm so that it comes forward. Now this down here is going to be a little bit darker because it's underneath these plants, so it's going to be darker. This side of the doorway up top is going to be in shadow, and then the light's going to be coming through, and so this flower pot on the wall is actually going to be a casting of shadow down. So the light will be hitting just a little bit on this wall here, and it'll also catch the doorway so that morning sun's coming in. The light in the morning is cool. As a general rule, I mean, there's always exceptions, but the earth is cool, so that influences the morning light. So the morning light is cooler. In the afternoons, the evening light is a lot more orange, a lot warmer. And I just work again that around that little clematis. I'm going to let that rich color remain as part of the flowers. Again, my shadow, I make the back edge of it cooler or bluer, and then I'll warm up this here. As I move forward, that gets warmer. And I'm painting on a gallery wrap canvas. This painting is 20 inches tall by 24 inches wide, and it's on a gallery wrap canvas. The painted image will extend over onto the sides. I'm not going to worry about the sides right now. And I also have to climb on a little step stool to paint the top edge of it. Now these flowers that are in this pot are going to cast some shadows down too. I'm having flowers in here, so I'm not going to worry about painting much further down. This is all going to be in shadow up here. And then these flowers will catch the light coming through. Now it's just a matter of coming back in and working around my clematis flowers. And I'll add more shape to them when I paint them, but this kind of just gets the canvas covered. I'll come back in and paint leaves. That gives you the basic feel of painting the adobe wall. And the most important thing is to give dimension you want to have the cooler color going back on your back edges. And then, like, I'm going to just bring a little highlight onto this edge here to bring that forward. But you can see, as the wall goes back, it gets cooler, bluer, and also this edge of the door frame gets cooler as it goes back. And then the same thing here on the gate, that gets cooler toward the back. I appreciate you following along. Please visit my blog because you can see the rest of the steps in this painting. I always put a link in the copy of my blog to, or the copy of my YouTube video to the blog, and then also at the end of the YouTube video I have the general URL address of my blog. So thank you for following along today. I really appreciate it, and you have a wonderful, wonderful day. Happy painting!